Okay, I know you really, really would like to see a little bit of something about electric fields or something. So let's look at the electric field, all right? I'd like to look at the electric field in this case, maybe of four charges. One, two, three, four, and I want to arrange them in a square, right? And these ones here I want to be positively charged, these ones here I want to be negatively charged, all right? And I'd like to say, in this line along the center, what is the electric field? What is the electric field along that line, all right? So this should supplement what we've done in class, or will do in class, depending on when you're watching this. And so it's a little bit harder than some of the easier problems on your homework, but harder than what we did in class. Okay, so what I've got are four charges, or I guess four charged objects. We want to keep that in mind. So we have four charged objects. The left ones are positively charged. And I think we'll make them just equal to Q, right? And the right charges QR is equal to minus Q. I want to have these guys equal so that we can make some nice cancellations along this line. And they're arranged in a square. And so we have to choose what this side length is, and we'll just call it A. All right. So side A. All right. And what would we like to find? We'd like to find the field along the center line. So find the electric field on the center line. When I write this in the homework, when I try to specify this, I usually use a lot more words to say something like that because that's a little bit confusing sometimes. So that'll be E of X. All right. Let's see here. Then what'll we do? Let's use a fairly simple setup situation. So let's use this, let's say, as if it were a type C problem. Let's say the concept is a Coulomb field. And so the equation there is E of charge N at some place x0, right, is equal to the charge of N over 4 pi epsilon naught times the direction from the position of N to the field point divided by the square of the distance between them. Okay, so that's what we've got going on there. We need a setup. And that setup is going to exploit this symmetry, right? So we're going to say we've got this nice symmetry. We're going to try to keep that symmetry along the x-axis. Again, that's why I chose this in the first place. So place center line on x-axis. Place positive charges at x n is equal to, I haven't named them, but I'll just say that The x component here is going to be minus a over 2, minus a over 2 in the x hat direction, plus or minus a over 2 in the y hat direction, depending on which one it is. So, you know, maybe call this 1, 2, 3, 4, or something like that. Right? And I think we have everything that we need there. So we can, we want to go with a strategy. Normally for a type C problem, I'd have you plot something. And in fact, probably what I'd have you plot right away is the first thing on my strategy, which is draw the field lines. Okay. And so we do that. We have our positive charges here, negative charges here, and I'll go through and draw the field lines in just a moment. I guess normally I do this with a 1 and a 2. Then we're going to find the distances. Right? We want to find the distances, or the displacements actually, between the charges. Between the charges and points along, you know, this line here, right? So, you know, from a charge to here, right? So that would be R03, right? So we'll find those displacements, and using those displacements, we'll find the individual fields. Okay. And then we'll sum the left. We'll sum the right. And then just below down here, we'll sum them all. All right. Okay. So, let's just start though with, actually we can move this all the way up, but that's fine. Let's just start with plotting these field lines. Now, these are positive and these are negative, which means we can probably get away with putting these guys in like that, right? So remember, we want sort of to exploit symmetries. One symmetry we know is that we're not going, since this is positive and this is positive, we don't get these guys touching or anything fun like that. So this symmetry line is actually something that we're going to avoid drawing any field lines through. And each one of these charges is going to have field lines coming out or coming in at equal angles. They all have the same charge, right? So since they all have the same charge, they all have the same number of lines coming out of it. And we have a pretty good approximation here, I bet, with just drawing the field lines from the positive to the negative. And this guy is going to just look like that, and this guy will look a lot like that. Actually, it should be flattening out a little bit because of the opposite charges. And then this guy will come around and never quite make it to this symmetry line. And we could do some other things with this guy, but we will just let it go out straight. That's close enough for what we're going to do today. It's not particularly quantitative. And the arrows radiate out of the positive charges, right? Outward from the positive charges. Out from the positive charges. and then into the negative charges, right? Into. So those are what the field lines look like. And you can get an idea right now where things are going to be large and small, right? Just by looking at this. I'm going to say, you know, these field lines are getting pretty close over in here, right? So that's telling us something. These guys are getting farther away over here, right? So there's going to be something very small here. Then they get closer again out here, so this is going to increase. It should still decrease it as we get far, far, far out because we're getting farther and farther and farther out from here. But we'll worry about that some other time if we ever worry about it at all. So we've got this guy out of here. That's number one. Number two, we want to find our displacements. So I'm just going to look at the ones here on the left, and then I'll make some arguments about how to do what's going on the right after that, because it's all the same thing, and I don't see why I should do the same thing twice when we've got all these symmetries to exploit. Okay, so from here to some point along this line is 0 to 1, or 1 to 0, excuse me, 0, 1, R0, 1. That guy is going to be, we're going to take this, and the point on here is just x hat. So we have x0 minus x1, which is x minus a over 2, which is plus a over 2, the x hat direction. Minus plus a over 2 is minus a over 2 in the y hat direction. Then we have R02. And again, we can just exploit symmetries. It's the same thing with changing this sign. So x plus a over 2, x hat plus a over 2, y hat. Okay, so we're cruising along pretty nicely. And we can find the fields using Coulomb's law, which is way up here, right? So E01, or E0 of X, let's call it, is the charge. This is on the left-hand side, so it's a positive charge, so it's Q over 4 pi epsilon naught. Times this direction here, which is this vector, the displacement vector, divided by its own magnitude, divided by the distance. So that's x plus a over 2 x hat minus a over 2 y hat, all over the distance, which is the square root of x plus a over 2 squared, plus a minus a over 2 squared, right? So it's a square root of that. But then we're going to multiply by the square of this, which means we'll add 2 over 2 to the exponent. Add 1 there, so it's 1 over the 3 halves. Okay. So we went from 1 half to 3 halves by adding in the, or multiplying in this factor. So that's. That's for 1, not 0. And E2 is, again, going to be just the same thing, Q over 4 pi epsilon naught, right? With the same x component, x over a plus a over 2 to the x in the x hat direction. Now we're going to add the a over 2 in the y hat direction, and we have pretty much the same denominator. A over 2 squared to 3 halves. And that's going to make our sum on the left-hand side, right, our left-hand side sum, nice and simple. Because these y components, you see, are equal and opposite. So we add them together. Right, we add E1 plus E2, and the y components drop off. We only have that x component. All right. And actually, it's exactly the same in both cases, so we double whatever we've got there. So we have 2q over 4 pi epsilon naught over x plus a over 2 squared plus a over 2 squared to the 3 halves and x plus a over 2. All right. And now for the right-hand side, like I said, we can get this by the symmetry. And we say over here on this side, if we have q on this side, then we go to have a minus q over here. And x plus a over 2 here goes to x minus a over 2 here. And that's the whole difference. That's the whole difference. So that's 2q over 4 pi epsilon naught x minus a over 2 now squared plus a over 2 squared to the 3 halves all multiplied by x minus a over 2. Simple enough, I'd say, right? Okay, and then we just add them up. Nothing more to do. Add them together. That's 2q over 4 pi epsilon naught. And we can't really do any really nice reductions on this because of the 3 halves stuff. So we're stuck with the x plus a over 2 squared plus a squared over 4 to the 3 halves. X plus a over 2, I forgot the minus sign on that q, so then we have a minus, because of that, x minus a over 2 squared plus a squared over 4 to the 3 halves times x minus a over 2, okay? And you can go ahead and underline that and say that is my answer. It's not beautiful, but it's nice. So we could figure out where, say, a stable point is according to this field if we really, really wanted to. To do that, what we have to do is we have to set this equal to zero. So the stable point for a bead on this line, a charged particle on this line, would be somewhere in here. You can figure out pretty easily that it can't be right here at minus a over 2. It's going to have to be a little bit off to this side, because these guys actually cancel each other out right here. There's no net force on a charged particle right there. But these guys still are going to add up and give a little bit of a force on him, so there's a little bit of a displacement on where the actual zero is. Okay. That's all we have for today. So I will get you something new and put it up in a couple days. Bye.